हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू दिस ऑनलाइन कोर्स ऑफ स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ मटेरियल्स। सो इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड अवर द चैप्टर ऑफ बेंडिंग मोमेंट डायग्राम, शेयर फोर्स डायग्राम एंड एक्सियल फोर्स डायग्राम। सो आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट यू टू ट्राई मोर एंड मोर प्रॉब्लम बेस्ड ऑन दीज टॉपिक्स सो दैट यू विल गेट सम मोर क्लैरिटी ऑफ द कंसेप्ट्स। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर न्यू चैप्टर विच इज़ थ्योरी ऑफ बेंडिंग। सो वेन एवर वी आर रेफरिंग फॉर लाइक बेंडिंग, दैट मीन्स इट इज़ वी आर कॉलिंग we are referring to the pure bending condition. So what was the pure bending conditions? As I have told you, for like if this is a cantilever beam and it is subjected to a couple M at the free end, so how we are going to draw the bending moment diagram? This will be a sagging bending moment of amount M. So what we are seeing that the bending moment is constant throughout the beam. So it is one of the case of the pure bending. Also, if we are having, I have told you, like given you in the homework also, if a beam is something like this, this is a, let us say this is hinge support, this is our roller support, this is the load P, this is also a load P, okay. So this is length A, so this is A and this is B. So if you will check and you will find that the bending moment will look something like this. It is also hogging and this is PA. So in the section, mid section, that is this section of A, you can see the bending moment is constant. There is no change. PA here and this is also PA. So whenever we are referring to the bending moment or the case of bending, we are referring for the pure bending condition. So this is very this point should be very clear to you. We are not seeing about like when the variation of bending moment is there, that means the other forces will also come into picture, that is shear force variation. We have to see the moment, bending moment due to shear force variation also. So that case we are not dealing here. Here whenever I am telling like bending is there or in the questions bending is written, so you have to take only pure bending condition. So this thing should be very clear. And pure bending, how does it look like? There is no variation in the bending moment. The bending moment remains constant. And if you'll see the shear force diagram, so let me just show you both the cases. This was our first case. So what is the shear force here? Shear force is zero. There is no shear force. And if we'll check for this thing, this was our second case. Also here you can see the shear force will look like something like this. Okay, this is positive, this is negative, this is P. So in the region of, you can see here, this is our pure bending condition. So in the region of pure bending, the shear force will always be zero. So what points you have to be like keep in mind for pure bending? Bending, whenever it is mentioned in the question or whenever I am studying, you have to see, you have to take it as pure bending. That is first point. So bending is, first point is pure bending. Okay. Second, that means, it means that hidden point is bending moment is constant and shear force is zero in the that particular question, in that particular portion when the bending moment is constant. So these points you have to be very clear about these three points. So now let us see how the bending, why we are going to study the bending of the beams, the theory of bending, and how does it look like. So beams are essentially carrying loads in the lateral direction transverse to their longitudinal axis. So whenever beam is there, so this is a beam, you can say cantilever beam. So load is something like this. So the direction of loading is transverse. So beam is, the member is said to be beam only if it is carrying the load in transverse direction. So beam are majorly designed to carry the transverse loading. Okay, so this is the first point. The effect of lateral loads are bending moment, shear force and axial force. So this we have already seen in the previous chapter. So the loading. The transverse loading can generate the shear force, the bending moment and the axial force. So this is not like always be happening. There can be two of them, there can only one of them. Okay, so there maximum three reactions can generate and minimum one will be generating. So if the load is purely vertical, there will be no axial force. If the beam is horizontal, so for frames we are not talking. In frames, due to pure vertical loading also axial force will generate. So that is not our case, but in general the transverse load can generate bending moment, shear force and axial force. Now the under of effects of the load, lateral load, the beam bends and the longitudinal axis takes a curved shape. So if the beam is, let me show you here in this previous page. So if the beam is being bent, what is going to happen actually? So if we are taking a simply supported beam, okay, so let us say this is the beam and here the load is there. So what is going to happen? The beam is going to bend like this, okay. So this will be your bent curved shape. The beam will take a curved shape. And now we have to see the equation of this curve and how we can relate from this geometry to the bending moment generated. So this we have to see in this chapter. So the beam produced, you can see here also. So what is going to happen actually? Let me show you the diagram again. So you can see this some layer is there and here the beam has contracted and here it is extended. So the bottom fiber you can easily see is in tension and the top surface is in compression. Okay, so this is the result of bending in a beam. So this diagram also you can see here. So the moment is happening, the moment is there applied. So this is the tension side. So if the beam has bent like this, so this was the original position, here it has contracted, here it has expanded. So it is quite obvious that there will be some section or some fiber that will have the zero, like the strain will be zero, because from compression till tension it has to cut this line of original state. So that means there will be some fiber which is having zero strain. Why I'm talking about strain? Because if compression is there, tension is there, the beam will be subjected to strain, strain will generate. That means there will be some section, some point or some fiber throughout the beam which is having a zero strain, and that axis or that line or that fiber is known as the neutral surface. Neutral means there is nothing has happened, no compression, no tension, it is having a zero strain. So the beam produces an internal resisting couple to balance the bending moment due to the applied load. If the bending is going to happen, the beam will react and it will generate the reaction in terms of couple, that is known as the bending moment. This couple is generated by the normal compressive and tensile forces in the section. So this is the resultant of the horizontal tensile and compressive forces. So if this is the section, so here we are saying it is tension, here we are saying it is compression. So you can see a couple will generate due to the effect of these forces. Okay, now the internal stresses developed in the beam are known as flexural or bending stresses. So we are going to study flexure, or we have to calculate and we have to see how the flexure or bending stresses are developing in this chapter. This is our main aim, to find the flexure or bending stresses. Now the following theory is applicable to the beam subjected to simple or pure bending when the cross section is not subjected to a shear force, since that will cause a distortion of the transverse plane. So the theory of bending, what are the assumptions we are going to take in the theory of bending, simple bending? First is, as I have told you, there will be no shear, not subjected to shear force, it will cause a distortion which is which will affect the our analysis. So the first assumption is the material is homogeneous and isotropic. That means it has same value of Young's modulus of elasticity in compression as well as in tension. So irrespective of whether it is tension or compression, we can directly use the value of E, that is the Young's modulus of elasticity, because we have taken assumption in the initial stage itself that the material is homogeneous and isotropic. Homogeneous means at any point if we'll take the property will be same, and at the same point in any direction if you are going to see the property nature, it will be same. So homogeneous isotropic make the material having the same value of the properties, the physical properties, and in this case we want to have a constant Young's modulus throughout the section. Now transverse plane remains plane and perpendicular to the neutral surface after bending. So whatever is though if this is our section before, so after bending this will be plane only, this is straight. So this is the second assumption. Initially the beam is straight and all longitudinal fibers are bent into circular arcs with a common center of curvature with it, which is large compared to dimension of the cross section. So as I have shown you, so the beam will bend like this. So this is not look like a circle, so this will be a circle, this will be the arc of a circle, and the radius will be very very large. This is this we are going to see how this is happening. We will prove it that it will be a circle only. Now the beam is symmetrical about vertical longitudinal plane passing through vertical axis of symmetry in for horizontal beam. So there should be a symmetry in vertical direction, that is the fourth assumption. And the stress is purely longitudinal and the stress concentration effects near the concentrated loads are neglected. So stress is purely longitudinal, that is okay, but what is this like if the load is like this, so at this point there is a huge load and the contact area is very very small, so there in this region the stress generated will be very very high. So this phenomenon is termed as stress concentration, but we are neglecting this and we are assuming that the whatever stress is there it is uniform throughout. So these are the assumptions of the theory which we are going to derive in the next lecture, that is the theory of simple bending. So this is all for today. Thank you.